Ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the blue corner, Bharat Aliyu.
This next matchup and all the matchups from here on out, as I mentioned, will be K1 kickboxing matchup rules. Bharat Aliyu of Kosovo making his entrance to the ring right now. He's 30 years old and a two-time world champion. He's also fought at the King's Cup in Thailand back in 2008, so obviously has a very, very strong Muay Thai background. Obviously won't be able to use all of those techniques here under these rules, but is a very experienced 30-year-old. Comes in with 62 wins, 22 of them by knockout, with just 12 losses. He's also a multi-time national champion in Germany and a winner of the WMC Super 8 tournament. Is the Crocodile Bharat Aliyu. Up and over the top rope in true Muay Thai fashion here.
And his opponent in the red corner, Daryl Sigmon.
Daryl Sigmon is trains with Remy Bonjanski, the Flying Gentleman, a legend in K1, and certainly it has followed a similar path as Bonjanski. He's originally from Suriname, now of course living and training out of the Netherlands. And Daryl Sigmon was had a very, very tough fight last time we saw him here on Fightbox at Mixed Fight Gala, as he went against Sergey Braun, who we'll be seeing in the next matchup. And just really put Braun to the test in what was the fight of the night, in my opinion, at Mixed Fight Gala 16. And if you haven't seen that event, make sure you check out the schedule. Go to the website, fightbox.com, click on schedule to see when the next time you can see Mixed Fight Gala 16 replaying. Because it was an incredible card from top to bottom. And so far, the way things are shaping up right now with this one scheduled to be at 76. Other than that, he's got everything going for him.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will now have the national hymn of Kosovo, Albania.
Ti duke betuar ta lidhëm besën për shpëtim prej lufteve qa I largohet që është lindur tradhëtor kush është burë
Gentlemen, the following bout is scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds of K-1 rules action in the 76-kilogram division. Introducing first, the man standing to my left and fighting out of the blue corner. He weighed in at an even 75 kilograms. His professional record extensive at 62 victories, opposite 12 defeats, and 22 wins coming via knockout. Fighting out of Kosovo, Barat the Crocodile Aliyev. His opponent stands across the ring to my right and fights out of the red corner. He weighed in officially for the evening's contest at an even 77 kilos. His professional record outstanding at 44 victories, opposite 6 defeats, with 29 wins coming via knockout. Fighting out of Holland, Daryl the KO Specialist, Sigmund.
Can you fight the K1 rules? No push, no holding, and only one knee. Okay? Check in.
There's the bell, and we are underway for action here in this K-1 kickboxing rules matchup. Daryl Shipman, representing Bonjansky Academy in the black trunks from Holland, originally from Suriname, and in the green trunks, it is Berat Aliyu of Kosovo. Aliyu upstairs and downstairs, mixing it up very nicely with that combination shot. A little bit out of range that time. Shipman shrugs off that kick. Nice combination shots again. Nice to see guys throwing combinations. You're always going to score a lot higher, and your chances of doing damage are a lot more than if you're just one of those one shot is all you got kind of guys. Shipman is the kind of fighter who never count him out, you know. This kid's got a chin, he's tough, he's capable of taking a lot of punishment in there, and is capable of dishing it out as well. They don't call this kid the KO Specialist for nothing. You can't just call yourself the KO Specialist if you can't live up to it. But Shipman does have 44 victories, and 29 of them coming by way of KO, so he's got to be careful of the power of this kid too. Looked like Aliyu was looking for some kind of a jumping knee or something like that, but he was out of range, so he didn't quite pull the trigger on it. Shipman able to slip a few shots through the guard there of Aliyu. There's a little jab that found a home. Push kick by Shipman. Head kick blocked. There's another kick. I'll tell you what, this Aliyu guy got some unorthodox techniques in there that you don't normally see all the time. There's that bicycle kick again almost. Kind of feigns with the right and comes with the left. Hasn't been successful just yet. I don't know if he should be uncorking it too much right now in the beginning, because then Shipman will eventually catch on to it, see it coming, and find out a counter for it. That's one of those things that you want to bust out very seldomly, but when you do, you got to make it worth it. Nice little left uppercut there by Sittman. Wraps him up in the corner. And again, under these particular rules, the referee tells you to stop or tells you to break and then kind of separates you, but does not give you the command to start again. So as soon as the break happens, you're allowed to just go right at it that time as Aliyu goes to work on him. Now at the end of the round, right against the ropes. Good Lord, what an ending to this first round. I'll tell you what, he left it all for the close of the round, didn't he? Better late than never, as he just went on an assault. Just assaulting him right at the end of the round there, very, very successfully. Take a look at some of this action here from round number one. I'll tell you what, these guys played it pretty close to the vest for the majority of that first round, but then right there at the end, wow, things really started to heat up. Take a look over in the corner of the man from Kosovo, Virat Aliyu. Take a look at this offensive flurry at the end. Boom, left hand, knee in the corner. Got him a little bit off balance there for a moment. Well, that was a good round. I don't know, that flurry at the end tends to make me want to give it to Aliyu, because the round was so close otherwise. But you never know. Could be enough to influence the judges. Maybe it's not. Now we're focused on round number two here. This matchup made at 76 kilograms. Daryl Sittman of the Netherlands in the black. And Virat Aliyu of the green, trying to continue what he started at the end of round number one. I'm telling you, don't count out Sittman, though. He's got reserves that I didn't think he would have the last time I saw him fight. Might be playing possum in there. You never know. Coming out, he was southpaw for a minute. Now he's switched back to orthodox. He's switching back and forth constantly, trying to confuse his opponent. He's confusing me. At least he's confusing somebody. Nice shot there to the body. Tell you what, even when those shots are blocked or partially blocked with the arms, don't think that they aren't having a toll. There is a nice knee by Sittman. Nice little jab that time by Aliyu. He backs him up against the ropes. Caught him with a right hand on the chin, and that one stunned him. That one really stunned him. Then he shoves his forearm in the face just for extra measure. There's a nice right hand right down the middle by Aliyu, and this thing really starting to pick up here. As Aliyu landed a couple of good shots, he almost knocked his mouthpiece right out. Aliyu really looking good here in this second round. Sittman, as I mentioned, does have a chin and is capable of absorbing a tremendous amount of punishment. I tell you what, he's been absorbing his fair share thus far. Sittman looks a little bit dazed in the corner there. What's going on now? Looks like he's got a problem with his mouthpiece. Referee asks him if he wants to give it up or what's going on. Looks very confusing. Look, I don't know what the heck was going on there, but we're back to business now. Aliyu picking up where he left off. Jumping knee by Sittman, tagged Aliyu on the chin. He didn't even feel it. Aliyu's got such adrenaline in him right now, he didn't even feel that shot on the chin. As the KO specialist looking for the KO. Here we go, up against the ropes, and he just throws him down to the ground like a rag doll. Referee all over his case now, as Sittman starting to fire back now. He's had enough of this. He's done playing games. And we have got ourselves a war, ladies and gentlemen. Right hand by Sittman. Aliyu firing back. Sittman snuck one in through the guard. There's that jumping shot. He almost jumped right out of the ring. Come on. Closing seconds now. Aliu, couple of right hands, missed wildly with that left one. Sitman is making a miss, seems to have recovered now, and he'll have another minute here to recover between rounds. I would like to know what the heck happened over there in the corner with Sitman. It seemed like his mouthpiece, like, I don't know if it fell all the way out or if he had some problems with his mouth guard or if there's a different problem. Maybe he lost a tooth. Maybe he's got an injured jaw. I don't know what the deal is, but very bizarre situation over there in the corner. Take a look into the corner now. Berat Aliu, coach is all over his case. Maybe trying to show him what Sitman was doing, trying to explain what to do in that situation. And here we go. Looks like we're ready for round number three. Oh boy, supposed to shake hands and he got right in his face that time. Did Sitman a little bit of an intimidation there? Tell you what, the psychological factor in a fight is oftentimes just important, if not more important, than the physicality. Because if you can get inside somebody's mind, then that's going to give you a huge advantage. Sitman again going airborne now. Big right hand that time, reached way back with it. Did Berat Aliu, the left hand right down the middle there. There's that kick again by Aliu. He really likes that thing. He hasn't landed it cleanly just yet. But in this third and final round, I have a feeling everybody's just going to throw their cards on the table and just go at it here. Aliu, combination shots with his hands. Mixed fight gala from Fulda, Germany, ladies and gentlemen, live on Fightbox HD. My name is Don Royd. Thank you for joining us here this evening. And I'll tell you what, we've had some really, really close fights. We've had some bizarre fights. And this one is a nail biter. If these guys survive it, it would be a miracle. There's that jumping knee. Oh, he's in trouble here. He really caught a shot there. He's trying to suck it up, though. He nails Sitman back and forth with these two guys. Boy, they are really giving each other everything they've got, throwing everything but the kitchen sink, so to speak. Sitman may have caught one low that time. Well, the crowd doesn't think it was low. He may have not even caught a low blow. It may have just... That shot may have just adjusted his jock strap or something, I have a feeling. I don't know if it was low, but his cup might have just been out of place. I think that's what it was. Oh, there's a big right hand by Sitman. Caught him right in the temple that time, or in the side of the head. The KO specialist going back to work now, looking for that knockout, as he's done 29 times in his career so far. I'm sure he would love to make it number 30 right here at Mixed Fight Gala. Left hand down the middle. Aliu fighting back now. Grazing blow with the left hand. Boy, Sitman really likes to get airborne there. I told you this kid was trained by Remy Bonjanski, and he's definitely got that flying knee, doesn't he? Sitman, overhand right, partially blocked on the gloves, but that punch definitely made it all the way through. There's that flying knee again. Right hand. Sitman starting to feel confident in there. Trying to track his opponent down. He got his leg caught up in the rope. That's it. It's over. Round three is over. I don't even know how to score the fight. I have no idea how this fight should actually be scored because I was so caught up in the action of it all that I wasn't really thinking about who was winning on the scorecards. I just kind of assumed that somebody was going to win by knockout. Boom, look at that right hand by Sitman. There's another left hand. I don't know. I think that that Sutsu may have pulled off the first round just because of that flurry of offense right at the end of the first. The second, I think I may also give to Sutsu. The third, I'm leaning towards Sitman. So at least on my unofficial scorecard, I'm not a mathematician or anything, but that's 2-1 should be in favor of Aliyu. But that being said, I don't know who won that first round. It could have also gone to Sitman if they didn't lean towards it because of that flurry at the end. So it's going to be interesting. Let's go up to referee Mike Markham and make it official.
Ladies and gentlemen, we go to the judges' scorecards. Your winner by unanimous decision, Barak the Blood.
Aliyu gets it by unanimous decision. I had a feeling about it. I'm doing pretty good tonight on the scorecards, aren't I? I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen, I'm moving to Vegas. I'm going back to America.